Welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we will look into the questions from the chapter called Quadratic Equations. Hello friends, may I request you to please click on the subscribe button below this video.
The given question is, the sum of two numbers is 15. If the sum of the reciprocals is 3 upon 10, find the numbers. So guys, again this is a very easy and very straightforward question. So let us see how we can solve this question. So as per this question, the sum of two numbers is 15. That means we do not know those two numbers. So what we will do, let the two numbers be x1 and let the two numbers be x and y. So we are going to assume that the two numbers are x and y. So let the two numbers be x and y. Now, as per the question, it is given that the sum of two numbers is 15. That means x plus y is equal to 15. This is being given. Or I can write y is equal to 15 minus x. Let this one be equation number 1. I believe till here, guys, we are pretty clear. So what happened? I consider two numbers be x and y, and as per the given question, the sum of two numbers is x plus, that means is equal to 15. That means x plus y is equal to 15, or y is equal to 15 minus x. Thus I try to extract the value of y from this equation, and I name this equation as 1. Now guys, again the other part of the question, it is telling that the sum of the reciprocals is 10. Now sum of the reciprocals, so what is reciprocal? Reciprocal means 1 upon x. Sum of the reciprocals 1 upon x plus 1 upon y is equal to 3 upon 10. This is what also is being given, guys. I'm not taking anything from my own. This is also what is being given. So what is being given? 1 upon x plus 1 upon y is equal to 3 upon 10. Now guys, what we'll do? Let us replace the values of y here, or we can replace the values of y a little later. What we can do, here it is 1 upon x. So what I will do, I will multiply y in the numerator as well as in the denominator, x into y, so that my equation will be, in order to balance the denominator, I am doing this thing. Similarly here, what I will do, I will multiply x in the numerator as well as x in the denominator is equal to 3 upon 10. Or I can write y upon xy plus x upon y into x is nothing but xy. I can write it down, that one also, xy is equal to 3 upon 10. Or what I can do, or we can write, now here denominator is same, I can write y plus x upon xy is equal to 3 upon 10. Or I can write 10 into y plus x is equal to 3xy. Guys, just I did cross multiplication. I took this xy into the right side and this denominator 10 to the left side. So now let us replace the value of y from equation 1. So here I'm going to replace the value of y from equation 1. So what was that? The value of y from equation 1 was y is equal to 15 minus x. So that is what I'm going to do. Instead of y, I'm going to write 15 minus x is equal to 3x into 15 minus x. Guys, till here I believe we are pretty clear. I am just solving some the equations. Nothing, I am not doing anything extra or anything from my own. Just I am solving these simple equations. Or guys, you could see that this minus x and this plus x, it cancels out. And we are left with 10 into 15. And here is equal to, let me multiply this one. 3x into 15 is 45x minus 3x to the power 2. Or I can write 10 into 115 is 150 is equal to 45x minus 3x to the power 2. Or what we can do, let us bring the right side things to the left side. What I can do, 150 minus 45x plus 3x to the power 2 is equal to 0. What I did, this plus 45x when it came to the left side, it became negative, and this minus 3x square when it came to the left side, it became positive. Now let us rearrange this equation. If we rearrange this equation to the quadratic form, what I am left with? I am left with 45x plus 150 is equal to 0, guys. This is what I am left with. Now guys, you could see that I can take 3 as a common here. Let us take the 3 common from here, and what I can do, 3 into 15x plus 50. Just I took 3 common out from this equation. Now we are left with like 3x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0. Now guys, what I will do, just guys, I'm resolving or solving this equation, nothing else. This is very simple equation. Or what I will do, x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0 upon 3. Or I can write x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0. Guys, what I did, I took this 3 to the right side, so it became 0 upon 3. 0 upon anything is 0. So we are left with a quadratic equation that is like x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0. Now guys, here let us try to solve this using the factorization method. So if we use factorization method, here our a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 15, and c is equal to 50. Guys, I believe till here we know how to do factorization method, how to resolve a quadratic equation using factorization method. That is what I am doing. So here, out of this quadratic equation, x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0, I am getting a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 15, and c is equal to 50. So here b is equal to minus 15 and ac is equal to 50. So we should try to find out such a product whose sum will give minus 15 and the product will give 50. Now what we can do to get that one, here if you see, these things are really very super easy. So here if you see 50, what I can do, let us factorize this 50. 5 10 ja 50. Now guys, you could see 5 plus 10, I'm getting 15, but we require minus 15. So what I can do, 5 minus 5 and minus 10, if I take, I will get minus 15, and minus 5 into minus 10, I will get plus 50. So that is what I can do. Now I can rewrite my above quadratic equation, that is x to the power 2 minus 15x plus 50 is equal to 0, in this way now. Instead of minus 15x, I will write minus 5x minus 10x plus 50 is equal to 0. See, minus 5x minus 10x is nothing but minus 15x, and minus 5 into minus 10 is 50. Till here, everything is fine and it satisfies the condition. So now taking x as a common, I am left with x minus 5. Similarly, here I can take x minus 5 out is equal to 0, and we require minus 10x. So I should multiply minus 10. So minus 10 into x is minus 10x, minus 10 into minus 5 is plus 50. Or I can write the two equations as x minus 10 into x minus 5 is equal to 0. Because here x minus 5, here x minus 5 again is a common. So we got these two values. Or this particular thing I can write in this way, x minus 10, I can write in this way, x minus 10 is equal to 0, and the other one is x minus 5 is equal to 0. Or I can write this one as x is equal to 10 and here x is equal to 5. So guys, what happened? I got two values of x. One is x is equal to 10 and the other value is x is equal to 5. Now we have because as per the question, the sum of two numbers is 15. So find the numbers, and we took the two numbers as x and y. So we got the value of x as two values. We got the value of x two figures. Now what will happen when x is equal to 10, y is equal to, we considered y, what was y that we gave equation number 1, y is equal to 15 minus x. So when x is equal to 10, y is equal to 15 minus x, that is equal to 15 minus 10, that is equal to 5. So we got y is equal to 5. When x is equal to 10, y is equal to 5 we got. Similarly, when x is equal to 5, then what we will get? Y is equal to 15 minus x, that is equal to 15 minus 5, that is equal to 10. Or I can write y is equal to 10. So guys, what we got? When x is equal to 10, y is equal to 5. So in other words, directly I can write from this above, our conclusion is, what is our conclusion? When x is equal to 10, y is equal to 5. Similarly here, when x is equal to 5, we are getting y is equal to 10. Guys, this is what our answer is. The two numbers could be 10 5 or 5 10. That is what we are looking for, and here these are the answers. Similarly, this is also a answer. So we are looking for two numbers, and the two numbers are x is equal to 10 or x could be 5. Similarly, when x is equal to 10, x is equal to 10, y is equal to 5, or when x is equal to 5, y is equal to 10. Hope guys you understood this calculation or this process. This is very simple and very easy and very straightforward one. But still, if you have any doubts or concerns, please reach out to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you once I see your comments. Guys, if you really like my videos, please subscribe.
If you really like my videos, I would request you to kindly subscribe and also let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.